Hi everybody, it's Stephanie from Chosen Weeds Farm. I'm going to continue my series on the best plants to start gardening with, and today is going to be green beans. And I'm actually going to plant some green beans with some watermelon so that I have a succession planting. So basically, they'll be started at the same time, but when the green beans are done, the watermelon will keep going. And then when the watermelon is done, I will be having sweet potatoes come up in the same area. So I'll have three different vegetables coming up in the same spot. So we'll have spring, summer, and fall vegetables all with one planting, which makes it easy peasy. This is one of my areas for doing the green beans, and basically what I've done is I've mounded up each of my rows. So each row is mounded. I'm going to, and then I have one row over here where I didn't have enough to mound and the chickens got out, so I'm gonna have to redo this. But there's just a whole linear hole where I'm going to plant them. So you're going to, in the mound, you're going to make a row in the mound, you're going to plant your green beans, and then you're going to cover them. So I will go ahead and make my rows and I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm back and I have my rows ready. Basically, this is a combination of wood chips and organic compost that I made myself. Now I'm to the point, I've made so much compost over the years that I don't really have to buy any compost. So I put compost in each row, and then I've sprinkled my seeds. And some people are going to be like, oh, you have to get them a certain amount of apart, and y'all, honestly, I've been doing this for a very long time and I just sprinkle them in. I'm not worried about it. They're gonna be fine. With the watermelon, I put a bunch of watermelon in there. You can't see them because they're so dark, but the little light beans are the green beans, and I will thin the watermelon out when the time comes. But I just want to show you this little area right here. So these three rows right here will yield about 20 pounds of green beans. And I just wanted to show you that because you don't need a huge area to get a big yield for green beans. So that's plenty of green beans for your family, a family of four. And so you just need a small area. So what I'm gonna do next is cover them up. I'm gonna cover them up and water them in and just keep them watered. The way I do it, they don't need a whole lot of water because the compost and the wood chips, that all absorbs water and holds water and does a really nice job, especially once it starts getting hot. Now, the thing about green beans, just a reminder, if you saw the email, you saw this in the email, green beans don't do well after about 85 degrees. They just stop flowering. And so that's why I have succession planting. So, like I said, the green beans are going to be done once it reaches about 85, 90 degrees. The watermelons are going to come in. Once those are done, the sweet potatoes will come in. And I don't do anything with sweet potatoes. They come back year after year. And anyway, so if you have any questions, let me know. Also, be sure, if you're watching this and you're not subscribed to the email list for videos and recipes and things like that, that you get subscribed at www.thechosenweeds.com and subscribe to the email list for more videos and updates and things like this. Have a great day, you guys, and I hope this was helpful. Bye.